Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing an advice video for back to school. So I asked you guys on Instagram to send me your questions or things that you want advice on so that you can be featured in this video and I will answer them for you. If you are not following me on Instagram, go ahead and give me a follow so that you can be a part of the next Q&A that I do. I usually do Q&As from Instagram. So the first question that I have is from Kylie. She says, how do you juggle work and uni at the same time while staying motivated to attend all lectures? Always looking forward to your videos, Rachel. Thank you so much. So how do I stay motivated to attend all my lectures and balance work and school at the same time? So all throughout my 4 years of university, I always had a job while going to school. For me, it was always working a part-time job because school was always my full-time. So making sure that your priorities are set straight to know which one is your full-time and which one is your part-time to make sure that you're managing your time accordingly. But how did I balance? I always used my time wisely. So whether it was commuting to and from school, I made sure that I was either reading my books or studying for exams in that hour that I had to and from school just to make the most out of my time. And I also learned how to say no. So working and going to school full time is a lot. So you're going to have to make sacrifices in other areas of your life. So whether that's saying no to your friends when you know you have to study for an exam or you have a big essay coming up, or saying no to taking your friend's shift at work because they have to do something in their life, you say no because you need that time dedicated to school or just to have your own personal time as well. Staying motivated is always a big thing, but honestly, I loved what I was doing, whether it was work or school. So that's really what kept me motivated, was enjoying what I was doing. Now, that's definitely easier said than done, but really find the small joys in what you're doing and that will keep you motivated to keep going. So the next question is from HummerAsk603. I'm a commuter and I was wondering if you have any tips or advice on what to bring or do on your time-consuming commutes. Like I said, it's best to use your commuting time very efficiently. So whether that's reading, and sometimes I didn't want to bring all my textbooks with me, so I would either take pictures of physically take pictures of my textbook if I needed to just read like 5 pages or something like that, or I would take screenshots of articles I needed to read, or I would get a PDF of the book so that I can read it on my commute without lugging it all with me. I would make use of my commute to also eat. Sometimes eating can occupy your time as well, so I would pack my breakfast with me or my lunch so that I can eat it along my commute and maximize my time that way. And also, I would really like listening to books to maximize my time. So find either your textbook on an audiobook, or I would use the app Audible. Not sponsored by them, but I would use Audible just to listen to something unrelated to school, just to keep my mind busy and entertained at the same time. Now I started listening to podcasts, and this is a new recent thing, so stay tuned to my monthly favorites and I'll let you know like which podcasts are my favorite. Also, leave me comments below if you have any podcast suggestions. Anika T. Anderson says, notebook or computer for notes? So I don't have one set answer for that. It really depends on the class. So if it was like a math-based course, then I would really like to take notes with a notebook because I'd be doing my problems, my exercises in that notebook. But for most classes, I would say I used my laptop most often. This next question said, what are some great back-to-school breakfast and lunch ideas? P.S. I love you so much. Thank you. Love you so much too. I like to keep it really simple and easy with my meals, and I would always pack my lunch to go to school. So for breakfast, I would usually have something like eggs or toast with avocado and tomato on it, something really easy and simple to make in the morning. And for lunch ideas, honestly, I loved taking leftover dinner for lunch the next day. So whether it's like chicken and rice or sweet potatoes or vegetables or something like that, it's really great to just take in a container and reheat it if possible. But on days where you don't want to lug around Tupperware and maybe you don't have access to like a microwave to heat up your food, I would definitely opt for something like a salad, a chicken salad, something that tastes good cold, or something simple like a sandwich or a wrap. This next question said, did you eat breakfast before commuting to school? If so, any quick ideas for on the go? So those two questions really went into each other really nicely. So for breakfast on the go, I would usually pack something like making Banana muffins. I have a really great recipe, which is not like that horrible for you. So I would have like a muffin on the go and a piece of fruit, like an apple or a banana. I would make a bagel with like some butter or cream cheese on it and take that to go with me. Or something really quick and easy is like a granola bar or a protein bar. And then I would always supplement with a piece of fruit. Fruit is like pretty much my essential, and coffee for breakfast on the go. This next question says, how do you decide how to manage your schedule? So in managing my schedule, it would all revolve around my course schedule. Ideally, because I was commuting to school, I would try not to have classes 5 days a week if that was possible. Most of the time, the maximum days I would go to school is about 4 days a week. Once I got into my third and fourth year, just the way my schedule was working, I was actually only able to go to school 3 days a week. I would try to put two classes on 2 days, and then I would put that last course on the third day, so I would be taking five courses. Having my course schedule only be 3 days a week was huge, not only because commuting to and from school for me was quite expensive, so I would save on commuting, not only the money, but the time too, and I was also able to work on those 2 days that I wasn't at school. Depending on what job I was working, if I was able to put those 2 days of work either on the weekend or work 1 day during the week and 1 day on the weekend, that way I had 1 day, I would try to keep it like a Friday that I had completely off to just do schoolwork or film videos or do just like things for me, and then also have 1 weekend day free for like family things or socializing with friends. And time blocking my schedule like that was a lot easier to manage. That way I was like mentally able to prepare myself for the day. So if it was a Monday and I'm like, okay, I have my two classes today, then I knew that my focus for that day was only those two classes. And then the next day, maybe I was working, so my focus for that day would be work. And so on and so on. That way I only had like one primary focus per day, and I was just able to balance it that way. So yeah, like I said, school was my priority, so I always made my work schedule or my video schedule around my school schedule. So this next question is from Jen, and she says, I'm going to college soon and I feel like I'm going to be very homesick. My school is about an hour away, but I will miss my friends and family. Do you have any advice on how to cope with moving away? So this question is actually relevant to me now that I have graduated from university and I moved closer to my work. I moved out of my family home for the first time, and I am experiencing, you know, missing my family, my dog, and my friends over there. So my advice to you is try to fill that like feeling of sadness with something productive. So every time you're starting to feel sad or that you miss your family and friends, not only are they a phone call away, you can definitely call them and talk to them at any point. So that's also a great coping method. But I think you should fill your time. Anytime you're feeling that sadness, make it like a trigger for you to do something productive. So for me, every time I'm like sad or feeling lonely because I'm far away from my family now, I like to put my time and effort into my channel. So whether that means filming a video, editing a video, or just like getting on my computer and replying to comments, that's kind of my trigger. So that kind of like alleviates that feeling sad or lonely or whatever feeling because I'm doing something productive. It's really helping to take your mind off of it and not letting you just like, you know, be sad, be in your bed, or like being on your phone sad and being unproductive. So that is about it for my Q&A today. I hope you guys found this advice video helpful. I hope that my advice was helpful to you. And leave me more comments below. We can definitely continue the conversation there if I wasn't able to get to your question on Instagram. Once again, my link will be down below for you to follow me on Instagram so you can be a part of the next Q&A. But I hope you guys all enjoyed. Happy back to school for those of you back at school or at work, and I will talk to you guys in my next video. Bye!